I welcome you all for today's session 16, Unit 1 of Basic Principles of Multicolor Offset Printing. Let's see the topic in this session or going to discussion. Today we will discuss about trapping, ink trapping, types of drying mechanism in multicolor sheet fed offset process, along with inline coating, IR dryer, UV dryer, or high speed multicolor printing unit. With some multiple choice of question, let us understand the concept one by one. Trapping. Trapping is an acceptance behavior of ink in wet on wet overprinting of several inks. It means on the substrate, the ink overlapping, how much it accepts the ink one or the other is called trapping. The ink fitting is mainly dependent on the rheology of properties. It means the tackiness of the ink, so that the ink adhere well to the already printed ink, the subsequent ink must have the lower tack. Normally, the tapping will play major role in wet-on-wet printing than wet-on-dry over printing. The ink trapping characteristics with multicolor overprinting process. Spreads or chokes in a reproduction technology when generating the image on a multicolor printing process. We can see it in spreads. The ink trapping is calculated from the ink density of solid overprint patches with one or two or three colors, and it considers of the color sequence. The ink trapping calculated on the basis of the following formula state by how many percents of one ink lies over the other, and where the ink printed by itself onto the paper is used on the comparative quantity. Normally 100% solid is used for ink density checking. We may call it as ink trapping is 100%, then the quality of the print is good. The following applies for the two color over printing, means one color over the other color. How you calculate? The Fe2 percentage equals D plus 1 plus 2 minus D1 divided by D2 E into 100%. FA stands for following pre-user of the two density color overlap. D1 plus 2 is density of two colors overlapping each other. This is explained in next. So D1 plus D2 is the ink density of the two overprinted color. Then D1 is the ink density of the color that was printed first. D2 is the ink density of the color that was printed at the last. The D2 color is overlapping over the first color. All ink density must be measured using filter for the second color. According to the following applies for three color overprint. FA equal 3, 2, 1 and means third color, second color, first color percentage. So the formula is D1 plus D2 plus D3 minus D1 plus 2 divided by the last color into 100%. We will get the three color overprinting overlapping percentage density. The tackiness of the ink characterizes the splitting property of an ink film, for instance, between two inking rollers. The greater the tack, the more heat is produced in the roller ink unit, and the greater the tendency of fiber to pull out from the paper surface. Normally, the ink tackiness must be maintained according to the press specification. On the other hand, higher level of tacky improves the adhesion of ink to the image element of the printing plate or the blanket transfers down to the substrate. The ink tag can be defined as the stickiness of the ink, similar to the what you would feel if you try to pull your finger apart from the ink between them. Normally, the ink tagness will be found out by an expert by ink. The solid ink is put it onto the finger and by pulling the opening the finger, so that the stickiness of the ink is, we will define it. But normally it is not correct. It has to be done through the machine or the equipment. The term drying includes all the process taking place after the ink transfer. The drying mechanisms used in the multicolors are different. Now we will discuss about different types of mechanism in multicolor sheet fed process. Until we have studied of ink trapping. The term drying mechanisms includes all the process taking place after the ink is transferred onto the substance from the blanket or printing plate onto the substrate, thereby providing a stable linkage between substrate and printing ink. Depending on the ink buildup, drying is affected either by chemical reaction, which may come under oxidation or polymerization, or by physical process, which comes under penetration and evaporation, or by both combinations. We can use it for drying the ink on the substrate. The physical drying consisting of absorption, normally evaporation drying, and then oxidation. These are the three types we can use it. Physical drying is the method of observation, in which comes under, we have already previously discussed, it comes under both penetration and evaporation, oxidations or the chemical reaction. Even the evaporation also comes under physical drying method. The penetration is achieved by the interaction of printing ink and the substrate, mainly dependent. It depends above all the carrier viscosity of the printing ink, the vehicle, binder, and the absorption capacity of the substrate is also depends. We may call it as the fibrous materials, how much it absorb the ink on the substrate. The printing component starts penetrating with the transfer of the printing ink onto the paper and are sucked up into the paper by a paper capillary tubes. How much the capillary will absorb the ink. Consequently, the penetration substrates depend upon absorbency, and absorbing speed of the substrate will also take a major role to dry a ink on the substrate. The absorbing speed is determined by the porosity and the wetting quality of the substrate, even the ink wetting quality. Porosity comes under substrate. Next is physically drying by absorption. Porosity is characterized by the number of pores per area and the average pore diameter. Moreover, the absorbing speed is greater the lower the viscosity of the printing ink. If it is lesser speed of absorbing, then the higher viscosity of the printing ink. Depend upon that, the substrate will hold the ink, how much quickly or slowly dry. It will dry on the substrate. The dependency of the ink penetration behavior on the absorption capacity of the substrate. Penetration depends on the absorption capacity of the substrate, but also on the viscosity of the printing ink. It depends on both. Absorbing speed also depends on the wetting behavior between the printing ink and the substrate. Evaporative drying. The printing ink, this also comes under physical. The printing ink consisting of several components such as resins, pigments, solvents. The drying of which is achieved partially by evaporation. The below shown process will take place during evaporation time. Conversion from liquid into vaporous state and education of steam generated on steam loaded air is blown onto the printed substrate. The solvent evaporates when a printing ink is dried by evaporation. Okay, the printing ink is dried by evaporation means the solvents are evaporated in the printing ink. These are the ingredients, solvents, pigments, resins, all those. The drying process is determined by a heat and a material transport in the boundary film of the surface of a liquid. Normally, by heating, it will raise the material on the substrate. The surface temperature and the above all the air speed along with the substrate surface as well as the partial pressure difference are the main parameters of the drying speed. These are the first one is surface temperature. Second one is the how much the surface of the substrate will accept, and the partial pressure how much it has been takes place. Depend upon this parameter, drying speed will decide. Drying by evaporation is accelerated by additionally enforced convections, not by absorption. If you use the additional drying mechanism, evaporation gets accelerated. Therefore, heating will radiate. Hot air is to be combined with the optimum air condition so that ink dries very quickly, the solvent inks mainly. This dryers is optimized with the regard to aerodynamics, with the vertical blasts of dryers are used to for the drying printing inks containing low boiling solvents, mainly used in Grever and Flexo. In Grever and Flexo, extra dryers are used to dry the printing ink on the substrate. Next process is oxidation. In an offset printing, an absorbing substrate, ink first dry by penetration and then by oxidation and polymerization. Finally, drying of the printing ink film is affected only by oxidation and polymerization of the drying oils and resins. The printing ink film receives appropriate cross link and consisting against rubbing of abrasion. It has, however, preserve adequate electricity for the product to be used. Oxidation can be happened by air also. The oxidation drying of offset ink containing drying oils is affected without additional unit of molecular linkage with the oxygen from the air. There is no linkage will create. Directly it will oxidize the oils and resins in the ink. Through normal drying. The ink layer of the sheets to be linked should be supplied with the sufficient oxygen in the delivery pile. The necessary space between the sheet can be increased by powdering. Here we can use an anti-set-off powder to dry the ink on the printed sheet, and oxygen can be diffused in the piles. The powdering serves to a support drying in the pile, and it is also avoided smearing the image underside of the top sheet. You cannot get set off problem if you use a powders. Next, inline coating, IR dryer, UV dryer are the used for high speed multicolor printing unit. After printing a multicolor, it should, if you want to dry by a high speed, then we can use UV print or IR dryers or hot air dryers. Hot air dryers or IR dryers and UV dryers, you can use it. This is the next to the printing unit before the delivery unit. This type of units is used to dry the ink on the printed substrate. The infrared drying, penetration of printing ink is faster if the viscosity is low. Viscosity decreases when the temperature is raised. If heat is produced, then the transfer of ink film can be heated up together with the substrate by using a IR radiation source. IR drying effects in an offset printing can be desired in the following ways. One is lowering the ink oil's viscosity by heating results in faster penetration. If the ink is low viscosity by heating, it gets melt very quickly or fasterly penetrate onto the substrate. Oxidation in the warm pile is faster. Even on the heated chamber, it dries very fastly. Oxidation is accelerated by a smaller portion of water in the ink layer is applied on the printed sheet. The chemical drying process following the physical drying process is also accelerated by rising the temperature. The above processes are detectable in almost any kind of offset ink. The short wave radiation penetrates mainly into the paper. We have short wave and medium wave. The medium waves, the air is heated mainly above the ink layer. Experience how shown the optimum absorption of ink is achieved with a short or a medium wave of IR radiations. Moreover, the short wave radiators has a higher G value, and so it is called as NIR dryers, near infrared dryers. Okay. The work in the lower short wave range due to low efficiency and long wave radiations are not suitable for offset drying. Then infrared or penetrates, eraser penetrates is particularly important for fast drying. IR drying is most effective only if absorbent substrates are printed on. The absorbent ink is printed, if used on the absorbent substrates on the, if the ink is used, then it is most effectively stick onto the substrate. The IR radiators heats imprinted areas in the paper to which the results in increase the file temperature and an advantage faster polymerization. The temperature must to upgrade to 40 degree Celsius. Then we have UV drying and curing. This method is not as oxidation or penetration. The printing ink is based on radically polymerization vehicle. UV wings with the appropriate UV dryers are used to dry the UV ink, suitable for sheet fed offset printing presses as well as both web offset presses. Drying between the printing units, inter-unit drying can be used to prevent a reversal of the ink splitting in the following ink unit. A UV drying method, however, requires special ink containings, completely different binders and additional photo initiator to dry ink very quickly on the substrate. The color black prevents the UV radiation from penetrating the ink layer and the curing effect is less than with the chromatic colors or varnishes. Next we have EBC, electron beam drying method or curing method. Electron beam is a ionizing radiations of a such high energy is transferred, molecules are transferred into the vehicle of the printing ink, starts ionization process, thus causing the release of free radicals. This causes the release of free radicals. Today, electron beam drying is used with a particular printed product. So that it can be used for food package, even absolutely drying ink and other microorganisms are transmitted into the substrate. Not transferred into the substrate. Next, the printed sheets in the delivery are powdered. This is powder spraying method of drying to avoid setup or blocking effect. A firm powder layer is distributed by a compressed air, thereby preventing the ink for the freshly printed sheet from getting too close to the reverse side of the top sheet. The colorless powder grains serves as a spacer, ensuring the oxidative drying by inclusion of air in between two printed sheet. A general rules, one can say that, or anyone can say that, the rougher the substrate, more porous the grain should be, the thicker ink layer, because more powder is needed to dry it. The incorrect powdering can seriously affect the usual good print quality in a particular with regards to gloss. A hot air dryers with the ambient air blower provide a higher reaction of air, and as a result they vaporize the water contained in the ink and paper faster or quickly. The hot air dryers are also particularly effective in the drying of water-based dispersion varnishes. Additional ambient air blowers with a cold or a warm air may be expanded for a better drying and for a gentle treatment of the paper. Now, finally, we discuss with the multiple choice question. Dash is the acceptance behavior of the ink in FHR with overprinting of several ink. The options are trapping, backing, color printing, none of the above. Normally, the major role takes place. The acceptance of the printed first color over the second color. Even in a pre-press also, it may happen during color separation. This is the clue to answer this question. The dash is calculated from the ink density of the solid overprint patches with 1, 2, 3 colors and in the consideration of color sequences. The options are mottling, ink trapping, resistor and none of the above. The clue is ink overlapping over the one other. To check the density of the, how much ink is deposited on the printed sheet. Next, ink tacky can be defined as a similar to that you would feel if you try to pull your finger apart with ink between them. The options are ink resistance, porosity, stickiness of the ink and none of the above. Normally, if you put a Fevicol and if you pull your finger outside, then you will get the some different feeling. That is used for even ink tackiness is also find out. This is the clue to answer. Normally, the finger will not come so easily open. The term dash includes all the process taking place after the ink transferred onto the substrate. The options are ink transfer, print, wetting and dry. Taking place after the ink transfer onto the substrate. Normally, when the ink is transferred onto the substrate, it must be correctly adhered onto the substrate. This is the clue to answer this question. Dash is achieved by the interaction of printing ink and the substrate. The options are absorption, penetration, long or none of the above. Normally, the printing ink will depend upon the substrate acceptance capacity of the ink. This is the clue, how much it will accept the ink or overlap. Next is solvent ink is dried by dash method. One is absorption, penetration, evaporation and then none of the above. Even the solvent ink is dried by the capacity of the substrate, how much it will accept. Even extra dryers is also used to dry the ink. This is the clue to answer to this question. Dash offset ink containing dry oils is affected without additional unit by a molecular linkage with the oxygen from the air. The options are absorption, penetration, evaporation and oxidative drying method. Normally, clue to this answer is little tricky, but we have discussed in the previous question. The next question, penetration of printing ink is faster if the viscosity is always not higher. This is the clue to answer. The options are low, high, more and none of the above. Next question, the UV drying of printing inks is based on, even we may call it as varnishes. Dash. The options are low viscous, radically polymerization vehicles, polymerization and none of the. The link of the between the molecules will take place. This is the clue to answer this question. The printed sheet in the deliveries are powdered to avoid dash effects. One, the options are low viscous, set off for blocking, polymerization or none of the above. The clue to answer this, the printed ink on the substrate, if they dry quickly, then it will not visible in the reverse side of the printed sheet. This is the clue to answer this. Thank you all once again.